Mike Evans has had a historic start to his career since being drafted by the Tampa Bay Buccaneers at the 2014 NFL Draft. He has been an All-Pro and gone for over 1,000 yards in each season. The Buccaneers surely hit the nail back at the draft. Mike Evans has proven that he is one of the best 50-50 ball wide receivers in the league. If you throw the ball up to him, chances are he'll come down with it. Speaking of balls, this video is brought to you by Manscaped.com. I've nicked my chestnuts one too many times using your standard grooming products, but this year, Christmas came early because I just got gifted the new performance package by Manscaped. Let's check it out. Your jingle balls will thank you. Manscaped created the world's first all-in-one men's grooming kit that has you covered from head to toe. The Lawnmower 3.0 waterproof cordless trimmer is built with advanced skin-safe technology, which helps reduce nicks and cuts on your most sensitive areas. It has this cool LED light, which is really helpful for grooming on those cold, dark winter nights. Also, here's a stocking stuffer for you, the Crop Preserver Ball Deodorant and the Crop Reviver Ball Toner Spray. I'm not lying when I say this stuff smells amazing. This is a game changer, guys. And new to the collection is the Weed Whacker Nose and Ear Hair Trimmer. Guys, I had no idea I needed this so bad, but I'm so glad Santa hooked it up for me. The Weed Whacker has these 360-degree rotary blades and the same skin-safe technology from the trimmer, so it helps prevent tugging and tears. In addition to the products for your face, they now have you covered head to toe with their new and improved Shears 2.0 Luxury 6-Piece Stainless Steel Nail Kit. This thing is nice, guys. Every guy out there needs to add Manscaped to their wish list this season. If you got a special man in your life that's been extra good this year, make sure you get him the Performance Package by Manscaped. It's the biggest bang for your buck, and for a limited time, you'll also get two free gifts, the Shed Travel Bag and the Manscaped Anti-Chafing Boxer Briefs. Don't wait. Go to manscaped.com and use our promo code JDP20 to get 20% off plus free international shipping plus two free gifts. Again, thank you to Manscaped, and let's get right back to the video. Now, let's take a quick look back at how Mike Evans has gotten to where he is today. Michael Lynn Evans III was born on August 21, 1993 in Galveston, Texas. Evans attended Ball High School in Galveston, where he played football, basketball, and ran track. On the gridiron, Evans was named second team All-District as a senior after recording 648 yards and 7 touchdowns. Evans committed to play college football at Texas A&M University. Evans redshirted his first season before stepping in and earning freshman All-SEC honors after recording 1,105 yards and 5 touchdowns. He followed it up by recording 1,394 yards and 12 touchdowns en route to being named first-team All-SEC. Due to his success in college, Evans decided to opt for the 2014 NFL Draft. At the draft, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers selected Evans with the 7th overall selection. To say that Evans has stepped in and been good is an understatement. Evans has tied the NFL record for seasons to start a career with over 1,000 yards with 6 to tie Randy Moss. Over the span, Evans has averaged 1,210 yards and 8 touchdowns. He was named second team All-Pro and made the Pro Bowl 3 times since entering the league. In 2020, Evans has 563 yards and 9 touchdowns through 11 games. We now know that Evans has been nothing short of a stud since entering the pros, but how about those taken before him? With the first overall pick at the 2014 NFL Draft, the Houston Texans selected South Carolina defensive end Jadeveon Clowney. Clowney had a tough start to his pro career after he left his NFL debut against the Washington Redskins with a torn meniscus. He underwent surgery and ultimately played in 4 games with 7 tackles. Clowney played in 13 games the following season and finished with 40 tackles and 4.5 sacks. He was poised for a breakout season going into his 3rd year in the league, and he delivered with 52 tackles and 6 sacks en route to being named a second team All-Pro and making the Pro Bowl. He debuted on the NFL Top 100 Players of 2016 at number 49. Clowney went on to make the Pro Bowl in the next 2 seasons while averaging 53 tackles and 9.25 sacks. Ahead of the 2019 season, the Texans franchise tagged Clowney before ultimately trading him away to the Seattle Seahawks in exchange for Barcavius Mingo, Jacob Martin, and a 2020 third round pick. Clowney went on to be named Pro Bowl alternate after recording 31 tackles and 3 sacks. He signed with the Tennessee Titans in the offseason, where he had 19 tackles before going down with a meniscus injury that landed him on injured reserve. The St. Louis Rams owned the second selection, where they took Auburn offensive tackle Greg Robinson. Robinson had a brutal tenure in St. Louis. He played the majority of the Rams games over his first 2 seasons, before he showed up to training camp in 2016, 15 pounds overweight. He won the starting left tackle job, where he was often flagged and wildly inefficient before he was a healthy scratch in week 11. The Rams opted to trade him away to the Detroit Lions in exchange for a 2018 sixth round first-round pick. He played in 6 games for the Lions before he was waived. Ahead of the 2018 season, Robinson signed with the Cleveland Browns. Robinson took over as the starter after half the season and remained with the team for 2019. In the 2020 offseason, Robinson, along with Quan Bray, were jailed after being stopped by Border Patrol with 156.9 pounds of marijuana. They now face up to 20 years in prison. Third overall, the Jacksonville Jaguars drafted UCF quarterback Blake Bortles. Bortles took over for the Jaguars in week 4 of his rookie season before going 3-10 and passing for 2,908 yards and 11 touchdowns to 17 interceptions. Bortles was somewhat solid over his next 2 seasons in Jacksonville, averaging 4,166.5 yards and 29 touchdowns to 17 interceptions. However, he struggled with turnovers and even led the league in 2015. Jacksonville went 8-24 over the span. The Jaguars were busy building a stacked roster over his first 3 seasons in the league and decided to bring in some quarterback competition, but Bortles prevailed. He was inconsistent, but the Jaguars were a top team in the league and went 10-6 before losing to the New England Patriots in the AFC Championship. Bortles had 3,687 yards and 21 touchdowns to 13 interceptions on the year. Despite his constant struggles, the Jaguars shelled out a 3-year, $54 million extension to Bortles ahead of the 2018 season. It went so well that Bortles got benched in week 7 for Cody Kessler. The two were benched for each other a few times during the year. Bortles had 2,718 yards and 13 touchdowns to 11 interceptions in 13 games. Despite the flashy new deal, he was released after the season. Bortles was the backup for the Los Angeles Rams in 2018, where he completed a single pass. Bortles most recently signed with the Denver Broncos after a Drew Lock injury before he was released and then re-signed to their practice squad. Clemson wide receiver Sammy Watkins was taken 4th by the Buffalo Bills. Watkins quickly proved that he had the talent to be one of the best receivers in the league as a rookie, setting franchise records with his 65 receptions for 982 yards. He added 6 touchdowns. The following season started off rocky for Watkins. He started off slow and ripped fans on social media before missing 3 games with injury. He did return, however, and rebound to finish with 1,047 yards and 9 touchdowns. He debuted on the NFL Top 100 Players of 2015 at number 96. That was the unfortunate peak of his career. Watkins broke his foot ahead of the 2016 season and didn't return until week 12. He had 430 yards and 2 touchdowns. In the offseason, the Bills traded Watkins along with a 2018 sixth round pick to the Los Angeles Rams in exchange for EJ Gaines and a 2018 second round pick. Watkins struggled in his only season with the Rams, recording 593 yards and 8 touchdowns. The following season, he signed with the Kansas City Chiefs. Watkins is far from a star, but has found a nice role in Kansas City. More importantly, he had 98 yards in the Chiefs' Super Bowl victory this past season. He's averaged 596 yards and 3 touchdowns over his first 2 seasons with the Chiefs. Watkins is currently dealing with a hamstring injury in 2020. He has 222 yards and 2 touchdowns in 5 games. With the 5th overall pick, the Oakland Raiders selected Buffalo linebacker Khalil Mack. Mack had an impressive rookie season with 76 tackles and 4 sacks. He was considered a candidate for the Defensive Rookie of the Year, but he lost to Aaron Donald. The expectations were high for Mack in his second season, and he delivered big time as he went on to be named a first-team All-Pro and debuted on the NFL Top 100 Players of 2016 at number 13. He built on a stellar year in 2016 by being Defensive Player of the Year and becoming the only player in NFL history to be named a first-team All-Pro at 2 positions, linebacker and defensive end. In his 3 seasons in Oakland, Mack averaged 76 tackles and over 12 sacks. He held out ahead of the 2018 season in hopes of a new deal. Ultimately, he was shipped off to the Chicago Bears along with a 2020 second-round pick and conditional 2020 fifth-round pick. Mack signed a 6-year, $141 million deal that made him the highest-paid defender in NFL history. He was named a first-team All-Pro during his first season in Chicago. Over his first years with the Bears, he's averaged 47 tackles and 10.5 sacks. Through 10 games in 2020, Mack has 36 tackles and 6.5 sacks. The Atlanta Falcons own the 6th selection, where they took Texas A&M offensive tackle Jake Matthews. His father Bruce was a Hall of Fame offensive lineman, and his cousin Clay was a Green Bay Packers linebacker. Jake had an awful start to his pro career and was rated the worst tackle in the league by Pro Football Focus. Luckily, he rebounded and was named the 3rd most improved player in the league a season later by Pro Football Focus. He's groomed into a good pro tackle, and in 2018 landed a 5-year, $75 million extension. He went on to make his first Pro Bowl on the season. Matthews has played in all 10 games for the Falcons in 2020. And finally, with the 7th pick at the 2014 NFL Draft, the Tampa Bay Buccaneers selected Texas A&M wide receiver Mike Evans. Evans has been named an All-Pro every season and has been a monster in the pros. He's recorded over 1,000 yards in every season since entering the league, tied with Randy Moss, who held the record with 6 to start his career. The future is bright for Evans, and it's still just getting started. Thanks for watching. Follow us on Instagram and Twitter for more J&D. We read all of our DMs and love hearing what you guys have to say.